Have you ever had a delicious tasting chocolate bar, or even had a nice hot cup of chocolate on a cold winter day? Have you ever wondered where your chocolates came from? Hi, my name is David Gopalcha, and I'm a research fellow at the University of Nottingham, and I'm interested in understanding the fermentation of cocoa beans and finding ways to improve the flavor and quality of chocolates. Our story starts thousands of miles away, close to the equator.
Greetings from Colombia.
You see, cocoa is the principal ingredient used to make chocolate, and cocoa is made from cocoa beans. The beans are the seeds from the mature fruits of the cacao tree, a tropical plant native to the Amazon rainforest. Over the centuries, humans have brought cocoa to other continents. And today, it's cultivated in many tropical countries close to the equator. Most of our cocoa, about 70%, comes from West Africa, with Ivory Coast and Ghana by far being the two largest producers. But Latin America, the Caribbean, Asia, and Oceania are also important producing regions, and about 5 million tons of cocoa are produced globally each year. About 5 to 6 million farmers grow cocoa, with more than 90% of the world's cocoa beans are grown and harvested on small, family-run farms. Growing cocoa is no simple task. The cocoa tree is a delicate and sensitive plant. It requires high rainfall and temperatures to grow, as well as shade trees to protect it from too much light and damage caused by wind. Because the trees are so sensitive to these conditions, they only grow best in tropical regions around the equator where the climate is suitable. Farmers must protect the trees from wind and sun, fertilize the soil, and watch for signs of disease or distress. With proper care, most cocoa trees can mature to bear fruit by the fourth or fifth year after the seedlings are planted, and this can continue for another 30 years. A typical pod contains 30 to 40 beans, and a tree can produce about 30 pods every year. Approximately 400 beans are required to make 1 pound of cocoa. Most countries have two periods of peak harvest, a main harvest and a smaller minor harvest. When the fruits have ripened, the farmers use long-handled steel tools to reach the pods and cut them without wounding the soft bark of the tree. The pods are then collected and cracked open to extract the cocoa beans, together with the creamy, white, sweet mucilage covering them called the pulp. After the beans have been removed from the pods, they are packed into boxes, baskets or heaps, and then covered with mats or banana leaves for up to 7 days. During this time, the beans ferment and many of the desirable flavor compounds are formed while undesirable ones are broken down. This process has a huge impact on cocoa quality and taste. After fermentation, the beans are dried, usually by leaving them in the sun for 7 days. The dried beans are packed into sacks, and the farmers would sell the beans to buying stations. The buyers transport the beans to warehouses where they're inspected and stored. Once enough beans have been collected, usually from many different trees and farms, they are shipped to a chocolate manufacturer.
Wow, this is a lot of beans.
Cocoa is among the most important agricultural crops. However, unlike the large agribusiness farm models that produce many of our major crops, cocoa farming remains a small family enterprise, much as it was 100 years ago. The challenges of low productivity, pests, diseases, and low farmer incomes all limit the development of cocoa farming communities. By giving farmers information to make better quality tasting beans, we will give them more control over their harvests and ultimately their livelihoods.
The Future Food Beacon, exploring new ways of feeding the world.